Hello, I hope this video finds you well wherever you are at this time in the world as we deal with this COVID-19 crisis, for lack of a better word. So someone asked me on my channel if I could make a solution to this string to end other in Python. So this is the CodingBat page under Python, string to end other. So let's start by reading this problem to make sure we understand it. Given two strings, return true if either of the strings appears at the very end of the other string, ignoring upper and lower case differences. In other words, the computation should not be case sensitive. And they give you a little hint here. They say, note, s.lower returns the lowercase version of a string. So before reading the examples, let's just do one thing. This problem, we have a function called endOther. It takes two parameters, a and b, which are strings, and it is not case sensitive. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna say a is equal to a.lower and b is equal to b.lower. And what that does is converts b to lowercase, and this converts a to lowercase. There we go. So now let's look at the example. So endOther, and the first parameter a is high ABC, and the second parameter is ABC, and it returns true. And that's because the smaller string, ABC, appears at the end of the larger string, high ABC. Now let's look at the second example. The smaller string, ABC, the larger string, high ABC, and it returns true. And that's because, again, the smaller string appears at the end of the larger string. What you might have noticed between the first two examples, and this is something important to notice, is that the smaller string is not always in the same spot. So the next thing we have to do in this is we have to figure out which of the two parameters, A or B, is shorter. So the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to make a new string called LSTR, which is the large string. And we're just going to set that to A. And we're going to say, make a new string called SSTR for short string, and we're going to set that to B. We're just going to assume A is larger string, and we're going to assume B is shorter string. Now, I could be wrong. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write an if statement. I'm going to say if the length of B is greater than the length of A, well, then we're going to flip them. We're going to say large str is equal to B and small str is equal to A. So I'm going to swap them. So now we get into the trickier part, and that is actually doing this comparison. To do that, we need to use the substring command, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to figure out the length of the shorter string, and then I'm going to use that value to pull out the last couple letters, or the number of letters at the end that match the length of the shorter string. So let's just paste something in here really quickly. So if I have something like this, if I have the large string as high ABC, and we see that has a length of 5 and the indexes are 0 through 4, and the short string is ABC, well, what do I have to do in that case? Well, I want to take the large str and I want to take out the last three letters because the small string is a length of 3. And using substring in Python, which is done with square brackets, I can pull that out by saying 2, 2, 5. Now, some of you might look at this with a little experience and say, there are other ways to do this using substring, and yes, there is. But I'm just going to stick with this format for this video because I think it's really important to be comfortable with this format of substring because it actually appears in other languages. Python has a bunch of interesting shorthands that are really useful, but I don't see them in many other languages. Okay, so if I say LSTR 2 to 5, what that is going to return, that's going to return ABC. And a nice little trick here is if you look at the difference between 5 and 2, so 5 minus 2 is 3, and the length is 3. It's a really nice way to check if your substring is giving you what you want. And then I'm going to compare this result. So I have to do some observations here. And if you look at a couple of examples, if we take a look at this example here, and I'm just going to pause the video and set it up in the same way. So just one second. Okay, so I wrote this other example here, which is actually this last example, because what I want to kind of help you do is I want to help you understand how to actually figure out how to write these in a general case. So in this first example, we can see that to get the last three letters of the large string, we go from index 2 to 5. And then I've written a second example where the large string is a length of 6, and we see that we pass it 3 to 6. And again, notice the resulting string is 3, and the difference from 5 and 2 is 3. The resulting string is 3, and the difference between 6 to 3 is 3. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and look if there's a pattern here. And the first thing I notice right away is that the second parameter is always the length of the large string. So if I generalize this, I can say lstr, and I'm going to go from something, I don't know what that is, we'll put a question mark there, to the length of the large str. So now what is this something? Well, what I have to work with is I have the length of the short string and the length of the large string to work with. So let's see if I can figure out how we get 2 from that. Well, we see that the large string in this first example has a length of 5, and we see that the length of the short string has a length of 3, and 5 minus 3 gives me 2. So I could rewrite this as 5 minus 3. Okay? Well, let's take a look and see if that same relationship works here. And the length of the large string is 6 minus 3, and that sure enough does give me 3, right? So we put equals 3, and here I'm just going to put equals 2. Maybe I'll come down to a new line here just to kind of. So therefore, what is it in a general case? Well, I see that this is 5 is the length of the large string minus the length of the small string. So this is going to be the length of LSTR minus the length of SSTR. And that is the general case. So therefore, I wrap this up with this if statement, and I say if SSTR, that is the short string, is the same as the large STR, but a substring of LEN of LSTR minus LEN of SSTR to LEN of LSTR. Let's make sure I have this right. We're going to return true, otherwise we're going to return false. So what I can't stress enough is that if you want to figure these out, is it's really helpful to write two cases that actually have numbers in them and then try and generalize that. So let's look if I did this right. There we go. So I hope that helped. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to send me a message. Have a wonderful day. Take care.